Students, once again I'm here to connect you all through online classes. In the previous video I have given you about applicable and most likely questions from the lesson chemical equations and reaction. This video I am going to explore some more important questions related to the lesson acid, bases and salts. Student, before going to discuss the question answers, I want to motivate you all to concentrate and focus on your studies. Children, what are the steps to concentrate and focus on your studies? First step is set a steady place. Children, you have to set a steady place that is naturally free from distractions. Okay children, the second one, create a proper ambience. That means you have to create a good atmosphere of place and focus on your goals with the material you are studying each and every time, children. And the third one is stop wasting time on the internet, children. You should not divert your mind for external sources. You only have to concentrate on your studies. And the fourth one is start with difficult work first, children. Always start your studies with a difficult subject or difficult concept. Now we shall see the 1 mark questions, children, from the lesson acid, bases and salts. So which of the following is an alkali? Children, you know what are alkalis? Alkalis are water soluble substances. Water soluble bases are called alkalis. Now which of the following is an alkali? Salt, dilute acid, strong base, water soluble base. The answer is, as you all know, water soluble base. Okay children, the second one is the acid with the higher concentration of hydrogen ions. So in this, here we have some acids like nitric acid, acetic acid, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid. So the acid with the higher concentration of hydrogen ions, here you have one hydrogen ion, and this is a weak acid, children, because after disassociation, it is like incomplete disassociation or partial disassociation takes place here. In case of acetic, you all know acetic acid is a weak acid, you can say, and sulfuric acid you have, and here one hydrogen is present, here one hydrogen atom, but in sulfuric acid you have two. So the higher concentration of hydrogen ions are sulfuric acid. Okay children, sulfuric acid is the correct answer. Lime water turns milky due to the formation of calcium carbonate, calcium bicarbonate, you can say calcium chloride and calcium oxide. So what is the correct option is calcium carbonate, because of the carbon dioxide liberation only lime water turns milky. Okay children, choose the strong acids from the following. So from these acids you have to choose the strong acid. This is acetic acid, sulfuric acid, carbonic acid and nitric acid. Okay, when I was explaining about acids, organic acids and inorganic acids, I told you children, organic acids are the acids which are obtained from the animal and plant products. So acetic acid is obtained from vinegar and product, but you have these two, that is sulfuric acid and nitric acid. These are strong acids, we can say these are mineral acids. So the strong acids are H2SO4 and HNO3. Now we shall see what are the concepts you have to concentrate on, children. After 1 mark questions, the basic concepts you have to concentrate in this lesson is about acid, bases and salts, and then detecting an acid or a base. How do you detect an acid with a base? And then common reactions of acids and bases, importance of pH in everyday life, then salts and chemicals made from common salt, then water of crystallization. So these are the basic concepts you have to concentrate, children, for your exam. During summer season, milkman adds a very small amount of baking soda to fresh milk. The reason is, children, baking soda is a base. Baking soda is a base. And milk contains an acid called lactic acid. Okay, children, because of the lactic acid, milk turns into curds or becomes sour. So why during summer season milkman adds a very small amount of baking soda? He adds base to an acid to become neutralized. Or because of the neutralization, the milk is kept fresh for longer period of time. That's the reason he adds base to an acid. Classify the following salts into acidic, basic and neutral children. Potassium sulfate, sodium chloride, ammonium chloride, sodium carbonate. So you have to divide into three columns. That is acidic, basic and neutral children. So you have to know what are acids. You already know acids are the substances which when dissolved in water disassociate hydro, which contains hydrogen ions. And basic, when acid is added to a base, they react and form a salt that is neutral. Okay children, now acidic means, so among these which are acidic? Now first is ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is an acidic. I'll tell you. Basic is sodium carbonate is basic in nature, and neutral is potassium sulfate, potassium sulfate and sodium chloride, and sodium chloride. We will see how can you justify whether a given salt is acidic. For this you have to know children, ammonium chloride is formed with a weak base. This is a weak base children, and this is a strong acid. Weak base and a strong acid. So when these two react, you get ammonium chloride, NH4Cl. Got it children? So your weak base and a strong acid, because ammonium chloride is made up of strong acid, it has acidic property. Okay children, now what about sodium carbonate? Sodium carbonate is formed the combination of NaOH plus H2CO3, a strong base. NaOH is a strong base. NaOH is a strong base, and H2CO, it is a carbonic acid, it is a weak acid. Carbonic acid, it is a weak acid. What it children? It is a weak acid and NaOH is a strong base. The combination of these two, you get sodium carbonate plus water. Got it children? So because sodium carbonate is obtained from a strong base, it attains the property of basic nature. Clear children? Now what about potassium sulfate? Potassium sulfate is formed by the combination of potassium hydroxide plus H2SO4, sulfuric acid. So this is strong base children, and this is strong acid. The strong base and strong acid, you get salt, that is K2SO4 plus water, which is neutralized. Adding right amount of acid to a base or base to an acid, you get a salt which has property of neutral. Clear children? Okay, and what about sodium chloride? Sodium chloride is formed NaOH, that is strong base, when made to react with strong acid. This is strong base and this is strong acid. A base to an acid will get a salt which is neutralized. Through neutralized process you get a salt, that is NaCl plus water, which has the property of neutral. That's why potassium sulfate and sodium chloride are neutral. Sodium carbonate is basic because it is formed from a strong base, and ammonium chloride is acidic because it is formed from a strong acid. Next question is, the vegetable soup pH was found to be 6.5. A vegetable soup, the pH was found to be 6.5. How is this likely to be? Justify answer. So you know the pH scale children. If you take a scale 0 to 14, here you have 7. 7 shows neutral. On pH paper, it is green in color. Okay children. And from 7 to 14, as you go on increasing the number, it is basic property. You all know this. And when you come down from 7 to 0, it is acidic property. Acidic property. Now 6.5 is here children. So you have to tell whether it is acidic or basic. It is acidic. It is weak acidic. As you come down, that is the number decreases. In case of acidic property, as the number decreases, the acidic nature goes on increasing. In case of basic property, the number goes on increasing, the basic property increases. So 6.5 is a weak acid, you can say. It is slightly weak acid. Understood? And because it is acidic in nature, it will be slightly sour. So slightly sour. So the vegetable soup pH was found to be 6.5. So justify answer, it is slightly weak acid, weak acidic in nature, or you can say it is weakly acidic. It is weakly acidic and it is slightly sour to taste. Slightly sour to taste. Write an equation to show the reaction between plaster of Paris and water. You know, children, plaster of Paris or POP. Okay, what is calcium sulfate half H2O? That is, we call it as calcium sulfate hemihydrate. What is the chemical name of it? Calcium sulfate half means hemihydrate. Hemihydrate. So when this is made to react with water, so water, that is 1.5, or you can write 3/2. 2 ones are 2, 2 plus 1 3, 3/2. Then you get a compound, that is calcium sulfate 2H2O. We call this as gypsum, GY, gypsum, or you call it as calcium dihydrate. Calcium di, two molecules of water, so dihydrate. So plaster of Paris, when made to react with water, you get calcium dihydrate or gypsum. What would be the color of litmus in a solution of sodium carbonate? Just now we discussed, children, sodium carbonate. Okay, how is the sodium carbonate formed? With a strong base. It is formed with a strong base and a weak acid. That is strong base, sodium hydroxide with a weak base, carbonic acid. Okay, so you get Na2CO3 plus water. So it is a strong, obtained from a strong base, it has the property of basic property. It has the property of basic. So basis turns what? Red litmus paper to blue. Basis turn red litmus paper to blue. So what will be the color litmus paper? Blue color. What is the action of litmus on dry ammonia gas? And B, solution of ammonia gas in water. So what is the action of litmus on dry ammonia gas? Well, now children, dry ammonia gas doesn't, with the litmus paper, there is no change. There is no change in color. You know why? Because dry ammonia gas doesn't have any ions. Because dry ammonia gas doesn't have any ions. Or when you disassociate in water, there are no formation of ions. So there is no change in color. Then what about solution of ammonia gas in water? So ammonia, NH3, when you dissolve in water, you get ammonium hydroxide. What you get? Ammonium hydroxide. Hydroxide. So ammonium hydroxide, it contains OH group, so it is a base. So bases turn red litmus paper to blue. Red litmus paper to blue. Got it, children? So because it is a base, it turns red litmus paper to blue. Name the three products of chloroalkali process. So do three components are, three products are formed. The first one is NaOH and the second one is chlorine gas and the third one is hydrogen gas. So these are the three important products obtained during the process of chloroalkali method. So, and they asked you to write important materials that can be prepared from each of these products. So they asked you the uses also, children. So sodium hydroxide, it is used in the manufacture of soap. It is used in the manufacture of soap. Second one, soap and detergents. Soaps and detergents. And also used in paper making. Okay, children. Then what about chlorine? Chlorine is used as a pesticide. It is used as a pesticide. And it is also used in making PVC. Polyvinyl chloride, a polymer. And also it is used in the preparation of CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons. What about hydrogen gas? Hydrogen gas is used as a fuel. Used as a fuel, children. Second one, used in the preparation of ammonia fertilizers. Preparation of ammonia fertilizers. Okay, children. If the question comes, what are the products obtained from chloroalkali process? You have to write all three, and they asked you write the commercially and industrially important materials obtained from this. So you have to write sodium hydroxide used in the preparation of soaps and detergents, chlorine used as a pesticide, PVC, chlorofluorocarbons, and hydrogen used as a fuel, and the preparation of ammonium fertilizers. This is very important for your exam, children. Draw a neat label diagram to show the following activity or action of H2SO4 on zinc granules. For this, children, you have to draw a diagram. So first you draw a stand. Okay, children, draw a stand. And then you have to draw a test tube. You have to draw a test tube. Draw a test tube holder. And from this you have to pass a bent tube or delivery tube. We call it as delivery tube. And you have to take a beaker containing soap water, children. You have to take a beaker containing soap water. Now soap water, why we have to take soap water here? Soap water will allow the bubbles to move upwards. Okay, children. So now you have to take, this is called delivery tube. Delivery tube. And this is the soap water. And here you can see the bubbles raising up. And basically you are taking, they asked you to show the reaction of H2SO4 on zinc granules. So you are taking zinc granules and H2SO4 acid. For that you are adding zinc granules. When you add zinc granules, you can see there is liberation of hydrogen gas, and the hydrogen gas passes through the delivery tube and raised up through the soap water. And your question is, name the gas evolved. So what is the reaction? First you have to write the reaction. Zn plus H2SO4 gives you ZnSO4 with the liberation of hydrogen gas. So what is the gas liberated? Is hydrogen gas. Liberated gas is hydrogen gas. So how do you test it? So how do you test it, children? You have to bring a burning splinter to the mouth of the, that is close to the air bubbles. So when you close to the liberated gas, it burns with a pop sound. Pop sound. So the pop sound is the indication of hydrogen gas. The liberated gas is hydrogen gas. Understood, children? So name the gas evolved. The gas evolved is hydrogen gas. And how will you test it? You have to write the equation, children. You have to write the equation. And zinc is a solid. H2SO4 is aqueous solution. And ZnSO4 is aqueous solution. And hydrogen gas is H2 is gas. So the liberated gas, when you bring close to the burning splinter or any burning material, it burns producing pop sound. So the pop sound is the indication of the hydrogen gas. Why is hydrochloric acid strong and acetic acid weak? Hydrochloric acid is strong, you already know children. Hydrochloric acid is strong because HCl will give rise. HCl will give rise to H plus ions on disassociation in water. So when you dissolve in water, you can see HCl, when you dissolve in water, you can see H plus ions are produced or hydronium ions are produced. So this indicates that complete disassociation of H plus ions and Cl minus, complete disassociation takes place. So this indicates that HCl is a strong acid. Okay children, then what about acetic acid is weak? So weak acetic acid means acetic acid when dissolved in water, partial disassociation. HCl will give rise to H plus ion and complete disassociation in water. That's why it's called a strong acid. Acetic acid when dissolved in water, partial disassociation, CH3COO plus not complete disassociation of hydrogen, still hydrogen ions are present here. That's why it is called as weak acid. Why aqueous solution of an acid conducts have H plus ions. Aqueous solution of an acid, HCl plus water, you find H plus plus Cl minus. So you find H plus ions which help in conduction of electric current. So because of H plus ions, aqueous solution of acids conduct electricity because of H plus ions, which help in conduction of electricity. Okay children, so this is the second answer. So third one, you have four solutions. You have four solutions A, B, C and D. The pH of solution A is 6 and B is 9. C is 12 and D is 7. Identify the most acidic and most basic solution. So you have four solutions A, B, C and D children. So A, solution A has pH of 6, B has pH, solution A has pH 6, solution B has pH 9 and C is 12 and D is 7. Okay children, so they are asking you identify the most acidic and basic. So which is most acidic children? So here, you know, once again recall the scale children, pH scale, 14, 0, 7. So 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So which is more acidic children? So 6 is acidic because as you decrease the number, when you come down to the number, the acidic nature increases. As you increase the number, as you go on increasing the number, the basic nature increases. Got it? So here A is highly acidic. You have to write A is acidic. Okay children. Okay, which is highly basic they are asking. Basic is C, 12. So this is basic, high, most basic. And then arrange the four solutions. You have to arrange the four solutions in increasing order of H plus ion concentration. So you have to arrange. How you are going to arrange children? Based on the concentration of H plus ions, you should arrange the numbers. So which is highly concentrated, that is you have to come. C you have to take first is highly concentrated C. Then after C, what you have? B. Then after B, the H plus ion goes on increasing. So they asked you concentration of increasing order of H plus ion. So you have to write first C, then B, then D, 7, then you in the increasing order of the H plus ion concentration. Then arrange the four solutions in the increasing order of their H plus ion concentration, children. For this, I told you H plus ion concentration, so it increasing. So from this level, the H plus ion goes on increasing. So from 14 onwards, it goes on increasing. So here 12 is the less, increasing means small to big. So 12 H plus ion concentration from 12. Then it is 9, that is B. Then it is 7, D. Then it is C6. So from increasing of not OH, H plus ion, they said. So as you move on, increasing from 14 to, it will be till 1. The H plus ion concentration goes on increasing. So you have to write 12 is the less H plus ion concentration, then 9, then 7, then 6. Okay, the number is more, but the H plus ion concentration is less because it is base. So they are asking H plus ion concentration. So you have to come from base to acid. Now give reasons, children, very important. Rain water conducts electricity, but distilled water does not conduct. So what do you mean by that? You have to give reason. You all know, children, distilled water is pure. Distilled water is pure because of it doesn't contain ions. It doesn't, distilled water is pure, which do not contain ions. Which do not contain ions, or when dissolved in water, they do not disassociate. And that's why, because no ions, they cannot conduct electricity. Whereas rainwater is impure. Rainwater is impure and contains ions, and these ions are responsible for conductivity. Okay, rainwater contains electricity, but distilled water does not. So here distilled water is pure, therefore pure water doesn't contain ions, therefore there is no conductivity. Rain water is impure and contains ions in it, and therefore they are responsible for conductivity. We feel burning sensation in stomach when we overeat. So why we feel burning sensation? Because in the stomach, due to overeating, excess secretion of HCl takes place, hydrochloric acid takes place. Okay, because of this, burning sensation takes place. Because of excess secretion, burning sensation takes place. And this we call it as hyperacidity. Hyperacidity. Okay, children. So hyperacidity is caused because of excess of secretion of HCl due to overeating. And next question is, a tarnished copper vessel regains its shine when rubbed with lemon. A tarnished copper vessel means, we can say in other words, it gets rusted. And again, when you use lemon, it regains its shiny nature. So what is the reason for that, children? The reason is, actually copper, when made to react with the atmosphere, it forms copper Cu2OH2CO3 reacts with the water and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere and forms a compound, and this is nothing but the tarnished substance found on copper vessels. So this is basic, because it contains OH group. When it reacts with the water and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, it forms a basic compound. And when you rub this with the acid, that is with the lemon, it reacts with the lemon and neutralization takes place and copper vessels regain its shine. Understood, children? So where actually copper reacts with the water and carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere and forms a rust on it, and when you rub this with the help of lemon is acid, it neutralizes and copper vessels again gains its shiny surface. State the reasons, children. Tap water conducts electricity whereas distilled water. Same thing I explained you before also, children. Tap water contains ions. Therefore, ions help in conductivity. Okay, children. Whereas distilled water is pure water. So, no ions are present. No ions. And no conduction of electricity. Okay, children. Now the next question is, dry hydrogen chloride gas do not turn blue litmus red, whereas dilute. Again, same thing, children. Dry hydrogen gas don't have ions. So no dissociation of ions and no change in color because no ions. Whereas same, if you take HCl, dilute HCl means you have to dissolve in water, you can see H plus Cl minus. So ions are formed. Because of the ions, we can see there is change in color. Because of the ions, concentration of ions, we can say whether a substance is acidic or basic. So because of the dissociation of ions, it is acid and it turns blue litmus paper to red. For dilution of acid is added to water, not water to an acid. So give reason. We should add acid to water, not water to an acid. Why? The reason is because adding water to acid is highly exothermic. It is highly exothermic. Therefore, acid is added to water very slowly. Very important, children. Write the chemical names and formula of the following. Okay, children. Washing soda. What is the name of washing soda? Sodium carbonate. What is the formula? Na2CO3 10H2O. Na2CO3 10H2O, or we call it as sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate decahydrate deca means 10. 10 molecules of water is present. Decahydrate. Okay, children. What is the formula for sodium carbonate? Na2CO3 10H2O. Baking soda. Now what about baking soda? Baking soda is NaHCO3. Baking soda is NaHCO3 or sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate. Then what about caustic soda? NaOH. Or we call it as sodium hydroxide. Okay, children. Then bleaching powder. So what about bleaching powder? Bleaching powder is CaClO2. CaClO2. We call it as calcium hypochlorite. Calcium hypochlorite. Okay, children. Now plaster of Paris. So plaster of Paris is CaSO4 half H2O, or we call it as calcium sulfate hemihydrate. What is gypsum? CaSO4 2H2O. We call it as calcium sulfate dihydrate. Calcium sulfate dihydrate. So these are the some of the chemical names of the following, children. So once again we'll go through it. Washing soda, sodium carbonate, Na2CO3 10H2O. Baking soda, sodium bicarbonate, H bicarbonate. Caustic soda, sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Bleaching powder, CaClO2, calcium hypochlorite. Plaster of Paris, calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Gypsum, calcium sulfate dihydrate. We'll come to the last question, children. How is plaster of Paris prepared? How is plaster of Paris prepared? So plaster of Paris is prepared by heating. We have to heat gypsum. By heating gypsum to around 100 degrees Celsius. How is plaster of Paris prepared? Give the equation. By heating gypsum to around 100 degrees Celsius, we get plaster of Paris or POP. So CaSO4 2H2O. You get CaSO4 half H2O plus 3/2 H2O. Heating 100 degrees Celsius. So by heating calcium sulfate or gypsum, this is gypsum, CaSO4 2H2O, on heating to 100 degrees Celsius, you get calcium sulfate half H2O, 3H2O. Okay, children, we have come to the end of the question. If you have any doubts, you can SMS me, or you can even comments in the YouTube, children. And in the next video, I'm going to explain you from biology lesson control and coordination. Okay, children, thank you.